Okay, so what we're going to go ahead and cover is going to be the bucket housing for the headlights on a majority of the older 1970 through roughly almost 1980 vehicles. A lot of the bucket lights housings consist of these halogen lights, which is these round lights with that type of plug. So I'm going to show you how everything goes together. Usually when you order parts, this is how it comes right here. So it's gonna consist of a ring that holds the light in place. It's gonna consist of the bucket, which also holds the light in place, which lines up with these right here. You'll see the little notches right there. And it only goes one certain way, just so you know, by the way. And then these notches right here, there's another one over here. It's going to go into these, which is adjustable as so. Let me show you right here. As you screw it down, it actually adjusts right over here. Where's the other one? Oh, right there. And then it also has these little supports, which is going to be this right here. And you can order it off of eBay. And then this screw right here, which is an adjuster, screws into that right there. Now, as for your spring, there is a left and right spring. They actually do look different, and it looks exactly like this. The hook on a left and right one, they'll face a different manner, but you'll see the little hole right there, and this actually goes into that right there. You're gonna push it in as far in as you can, and that hook actually goes into this notch right here, which is only gonna be one. It's not gonna go into the housing itself, just so you know. It goes into this, and as you tighten it down, these tabs, that actually tightens itself and it stays in place like this. Like you see, it's pretty tight, right? This right here is what mounts into your frame or your front radiator support, and these are the bolt types that you would use right here. So that's what they look like. So it's two here, and then it's gonna be two right here on the top, or as you see right there, it's this type, and it goes into your front fender or your front housing. The way it sits in there is going to be as such. You're gonna get your light, you're gonna sit it in to the housing, and then you put your ring over it, which sits directly over, and that literally is what holds it on. And then you see these little holes right there, you just line up the tabs with the holes. And you get your little screws like this. And you're just gonna go ahead and you're gonna screw it in. It could be any type of screw, as long as it fits in there. And you're just gonna screw it into there and just tighten it down. Basically, that's what keeps it in place. That keeps your light in place. And you can go ahead and mount that onto your vehicle. These only go one way, and this is the same thing. This only goes one way as well on here, okay? So just as long as you pay attention, if you notice, look at the tab. See how that only goes to there and that only goes to there? And then this goes to right there. Okay, so this one, when you put it in there, it only goes for that side, okay, for the front driver side. And then this is the headlight for the front passenger side, and the exact same thing. The bucket only goes a certain way, and usually that notch is going to face up, okay? Then the headlight falls into place, and then you put your ring over, as such, and that retains and holds your headlight. So that's an easy walkthrough on how to go ahead and do your headlight for your bucket. I know that there's no videos on YouTube, so hopefully this helps out a lot of people in how to go ahead and service them, change them out.